Good afternoon. The announcements for this week are on Sunday, January 14th. There will not be CCD classes for grades 6 through 8. On Monday, January 15th, there won't be CCD classes for grades 1 through 5. Sunday, January 14th, the Catholic Daughters of the Americas will be having a meeting and Christmas luncheon following the 11 a.m. Mass. Thursday, January 18th, there will be a charismatic prayer meeting in the church at 6:30 p.m. The parish bulletin can be viewed by going to the parish's website, ReverendFrankKarwacki.net. Last Sunday, on the Feast of the Epiphany, the familiar story of the Magi, who, directed by the star to Bethlehem, find the baby Jesus. Today we hear of the first disciples who, directed by John the Baptist, encounter the adult Jesus. That initial encounter changes the entire course of their lives. Andrew insists to his brother Simon, "We have found the Messiah." Our encounter with the Lord, here and elsewhere, influenced the way we live our lives as well. In a special way, we remember Debbie Donnelly during this Mass.
Let's do our family prayer. Loving and faithful God, through the years, the people of our diocese, I appreciate the prayers of Our Lady Immaculate Conception, patrons of the USA, as well as the intercession St. John Neumann and St. Catherine Drexel, who served in our diocese and are helped by their intercession in times of war, disasters, violence, drug abuse, homelessness, and terrorism. We pray to give us your wisdom that we build a community founded on the values of Jesus, which gives respect to life and dignity of all human life from conception to death. Help us to value one man and one woman who come together in holy matrimony in order to create a loving home for children who are conceived in a sacred union and not destroy their conception. Help us to value our elderly whom we treat with dignity and to end their lives. Help us to preserve our religious freedom as guaranteed by the U.S. Constitution. Help us to foster and promote vocation in our family and acquaintances. Hear our prayer and give us the perseverance to be a voice for the life and dignity in our country. St. John Neumann and St. Catherine Drexel, hasten to help us to pray we be a holy family. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We offer this Hail Mary for the fire trucks or wherever they're going, whatever situation is going on there. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. Do thou with me to bring us. Pass it to all Satan and all the other evil spirits. Proud to seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Please join in singing our opening hymn number 654 in the music issue, Give Me Ears to Listen, number 654.
Let me be your servant, let me walk your way. Guide me on your path, the light of day.
Let me be a
sure foundation, pure and strong.
Let me tell of your salvation
all night long.
Give me ears to listen,
give me eyes to see. Give me words to speak and show your face to me.
Give me courage from the storms when they
arise.
Give me ears to
heard you call my name.
Refresh my soul, I felt your burning flames. Oh, strengthen me to bear that cross and walk your way.
Give me
peace to comfort those with all
I say. Give me ears to listen, give me
eyes to see.
Give me words to speak and show your face to me.
At the conclusion of the Mass, we're going to have Briella, our altar server from Our Lady of Lourdes School, to speak on behalf of the Catholic Schools Week. So we're looking forward to hearing her at the conclusion of the Mass. And also we have the blessings for the three kings at the side door on the two counters in the back. They already blessed them, so feel free to take as many home as you'd like to take home with you today. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let's acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy. Mighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who governs all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, lives and reigns with the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Excuse me. A reading from the first book of Samuel. Samuel was sleeping in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. The Lord called to Samuel, who answered, "Here I am." Samuel ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." "I did not call you," Eli said. "Go back to sleep." So he went back to sleep. Again the Lord called Samuel, who rose and went to Eli. "Here I am," he said. "You called me." And Eli answered, "I did not call you, my son. Go back to sleep." At that time, Samuel was not familiar with the Lord, because the Lord had not revealed anything to him as yet. The Lord called Samuel again for the third time. Getting up and going to Eli, he said, "Here I am, you called me." Then Eli understood that the Lord was calling the youth. So he said to Samuel, "Go to sleep, and if you are called, reply, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" When Samuel went to sleep in his place, the Lord came and revealed his presence, calling out as before, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel answered, "Speak, for your servant is listening." Samuel grew up, and the Lord was with him, not permitting any word of his to be without effect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The second reading is a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the body is not for immorality, but for the Lord, and the Lord is for the body. God raised the Lord and will also raise us by his power. Do you not know that your bodies are members of Christ? But whoever is joined to the Lord becomes one spirit with him. Avoid immorality. Every other sin a person commits is outside the body, but the immoral person sins against his own body. Do you not know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you have been purchased at a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. To John. John was standing with two of his disciples And as he watched Jesus walk by, he said, "Behold, the Lamb of God." The two disciples heard what he had said and followed Jesus. Jesus turned and saw them following him and said to them, "What are you looking for?" They said to him, "Rabbi," which translated means teacher, "where are you staying?" He said to them, "Come and you will see." So they went and saw where Jesus was staying, and they stayed with him that day. It was about 4 in the afternoon. Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, was the one of the two who heard John and followed Jesus. He first found his own brother Simon and told him, "We have found the Messiah," which is translated Christ. Then he brought him to Jesus. Jesus looked at him and said, "You are Simon, the son of John. You will be called Cephas," which is translated Peter, the gospel of the Lord. In the first reading today from the book of Samuel, we find Samuel as a young boy actually living in the temple at Shiloh. The temple in Jerusalem was not built yet. So they had actually put the Ark of the Covenant, remember the Ark of the Covenant, that box that's like a cedar chest covered with gold, and inside that box was the Ten Commandments that was given to Moses. Inside the box was a jar of bread that came down from heaven when they were in the desert. God sent bread for them. And inside the box was the staff of Moses' brother Aaron, who was the high priest. And as you know, that box called the Ark of the Covenant exuded power. When people were in the presence of that box, they experienced God's presence. And they often took it out to battle, to win battles. They took it out as a nuclear weapon against their enemy. As soon as they brought the box out, the enemy was losing the battle. In any case, when Samuel's mother could not have any children, she went to the temple, Hannah, and she prayed and said, "Lord, if you would give me a child, a boy, I will dedicate him to God, to you, God, for the rest of his life." And what they did in those days, they took something called a Nazarite vow. So Samuel took the Nazarite vow as just a little child. The Nazarite vow would be that he wouldn't drink any wine. He would be totally dedicated to the Lord. And so he did all those things. And it reminds me of years ago, like religious life. And it was too early. They used to allow girls to go into the convent when they were just graduating 8th grade. You know, they're not fully mature yet. And they're entering and they're taking vows and everything later on. But they're in the convent, you know, living life. It reminds me of brothers that are like monks that also enter in and take the vows of chastity, obedience, and so forth. And so he had taken these vows to serve the Lord, even though he was a little boy at that time. So he's sleeping in the temple near the Ark of the Covenant and wants to be close to God. And the priest there, he's an apprentice to the priest Eli. Eventually, when he grows up, he becomes a Levite priest, Samuel. He becomes a prophet, a great prophet who anointed the first kings. Matter of fact, God asked Samuel, "You anoint, make them kings, anoint them." So in the reading today, he's just a little boy and he's sleeping in the temple. And he is waking up and he hears a voice calling out to him. And he's like, "Who's calling, you know?" And he goes, wakes up Eli the priest. "Did you call me?" "No, I didn't call you." And then he goes back to sleep again. He hears the voice again, God calling out to him, you know. "Samuel, Samuel," goes to Eli. "Did you call?" "No, I'm sleeping. No, I didn't call you." The third time he goes again to Eli the priest, and the priest said, "Look, it's God that's calling you. So when you hear him calling you again, you say, 'Here I am, I come to do your will.'" Say that to him, "Here I am, I come to do your will." So God was calling him. Yeah, God does speak to us, sometimes in a dream, not always. He speaks at any time and anywhere to us, maybe not in an audible way, but sometimes he can speak in an audible way. There are stories of being called. I mean, in a dream, as far as when I told the story at my 40th anniversary, a mass that, when I was waking up one morning, I was a school teacher, and the birds were chirping outside, and a thought came to me from, like, the outside, and says, "Since you're spending all your free time working for me, why don't you go full-time? Well, when I came out of school teaching biology, what would I do? I was going to three prayer meetings a week. I was teaching CCD. I was taking communion to the sick on Sunday. So I was spending all my free time working for the Lord. So that was true. He said, why don't you go full-time? And a light went off in my brain, you might say, and I'm 34 years old, and I say, well, I could be a priest, but maybe I'm too old. And so I checked it out, and once I checked it out, the doors opened, there I was ordained, and now 40 years later, I'm a priest. But if I hadn't heard those words, that question coming to me, I probably would never have decided to try to pursue priesthood. So God can speak to us in a number of ways at any time. I think of Father Horesco. I may tell you a story. We have a priest. He's now a monk, Father Horesco. And he was at Bloomsburg College studying. He was not going to church. And he had a job, part-time job at Bloomsburg, and going to the college there. And he said one night, and he tells us publicly, one night he went to bed, and all of a sudden he got a call, just like Eli, you know, waking him up. And he's like, who are you? I'm God. He said, I'm concerned about the salvation of your soul. You need to go to confession and so forth. He said, wow. He said, I was sober. I'm hearing you talk to me. And I got on my knees and prayed for the first time in years. Because once he left his parents, he stopped going to church, of course. And now he said, next day I called a priest. We went to confession. I started to go to Mass almost every day then. And, of course, now he's a priest. How about that? So God can speak to us anytime, anywhere. And we have these things called the promptings of the Spirit. Like a sense like to do something good, you know. I still remember when I became pastor in Caltmont, I had a gentleman driving me around. He knew where the home calls were first Friday. And he said to me, oh, look at that house there. He said, I heard that lady in there is ill. And I said, well, she's not on our list. But see, the prompting said, go see her anyhow. I'm like, well, let's stop and see her. So I rang the doorbell. I opened the door. She answered it, and she fell in my arms and collapsed. And I called 911. And we got her into the hospital. She survived. Her son was living in Maryland. We called him and said, your mother's okay. But if I hadn't done that, if I could say, oh, she's on, we'll put her on a list next time. But the promptings of the Spirit said, no, go to her door. And good timing. I see timing all the time. I think of, again, a story I wrote also when I was in the hospital, Holy Spirit, for 4 years. I was walking around. I checked that night who got into the hospital during the day. And I find a card in the seventh floor. It wasn't ICU. It wasn't the heart cardiac section. It wasn't oncology. So it's like not serious, too serious. And I thought, well, you know, it's already 9 o'clock, and maybe we'll see him tomorrow morning. But I got this nagging feeling, like, go see him, go see him. So I went to see him, and he's coming in with his suitcase. The nurse says, well, I don't have him settled in his room, but if you want to help him do something, yeah, I think I'll talk to him. So I want to go to confession. He's a very good member of St. Teresa's New Cumberland. And I said, I'll give you the anointing of the sick and the Holy Communion. And so then I went down the elevator. I lived in the hospital, went back to my room, and the elevator opened, and I didn't even get off the elevator, and I heard code 1, you know, case 1, room 721. I said, that's where I just was in room 720, meaning they're doing CPR on him. So I just let the elevator close, and I pushed the button to go up to his room, and I walked down, and there's the team working on him to try to save his life. And the nurse said to me, Father, how come you're not putting the holy oil on him, anointing him? I said, I was just here 5 minutes ago. He died, by the way. So when his family came, they were comforted to know that he received confession and communion and anointing of the sick right a few minutes before he died. So those promptings, I could have said, so I was saying, well, maybe I shouldn't go see him, it's late, you know, but I said, no, the Holy Spirit, that's the Lord speaking to us. In a variety of ways, he's speaking to us. He speaks to us especially. Even like for in the case of Father Horesco, he wasn't going to church, but he speaks to us when we're seeking him in a special way, in a variety of ways. And notice in the gospel today, the two apostles walking around, the future apostles of Jesus, and they're following John the Baptist. And John the Baptist sees Jesus and says, there's the Lamb of God. And they said, wow, that's the Messiah. We want to go see him. So notice what he says. They're following Jesus. And she said, what are you looking for? And he said, well, and they asked him, where are you staying? And in other words, when you say, where are you staying, they didn't mean, like, let's see how the furniture looks in your room and you have a nice address or something. No, they mean, like, we want to know you better. And in the rabbinic title, and Jesus said, come and follow me, come and stay. And then he spent the day with him. And that meant just have a discussion with me, learn from me. And, of course, they did, and they eventually became the great apostles and served the Lord. So the Lord is always calling us in a variety of ways, and I think sometimes we might tend to brush it off and think we're not being called. The key question is, we have to ask ourselves, does God speak to you and me today? I know he's supposed to be in the past. He continually speaks to us. And one of the things that in recognizing God's voice is that we might say, you know, well, first of all, maybe he wouldn't speak to me because who I am. He speaks to the biblical figures in the Bible and to saints, but I'm not worthy. But no, he does speak to us. But the fact is, we are the ones that lack expectant faith. We need to be more sensitive to the promptings of the Spirit. So God can speak to us in prayer, in our dreams, in promptings, like different promptings. You have the urge to do something good. He can speak to us time and time again. And he speaks to us in something that people call the aha moments. You know what an aha moment is? You go, aha. Wow. Instead of just, here's an aha moment. Say you have a couple that has a very good marriage, and the wife might say, aha, if I hadn't gone to that meeting and met my husband, I would have never been married to him. Look at that. I followed the advice of that person. Aha. It was a setup. There I am. Now I'm happily married. Things that are happening in our lives that we look at and we go, aha, look at that. I'll say to myself, if I did not go to the prayer meeting at St. John the Baptist Roman Catholic Church in Mount Carmel, the charismatic prayer meeting, where I got really involved and it prepared me to answer the question, yes, I want to follow you, Lord, as a priest, I don't think I would be a priest today. But I went to it. So different things that we're invited to, and then we look back and we say, wow, I'm so glad I said yes to that. Those are all promptings of the Spirit. So let's pray that we are more and more open, more sensitive to the Holy Spirit prompting us and guiding us and leading us in directions, and that we will be like Samuel in the first reading today. We'll say, speak, Lord, your servant is listening. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through whom all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, received from the Father and the Son, who the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us come now before God our Father as we place our intercessions into his loving hands.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, that we may be a witness to Christ, Christ's informative presence in our life, inviting others to come and follow and become disciples of the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations, that they may do everything in their power to build a society where justice is always pursued, where conflict is resolved peacefully, and where the dignity of every person is upheld. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That every Catholic will actively seek out their calling in Christ and work to strengthen his kingdom, especially those chosen to lead as priests or consecrated brothers and sisters. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the words and actions of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr., may continue to inspire new generations of Americans to work to overcome injustice, inequality, racism, and poverty. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died recently, especially Joan Martin, that they may be gathered into paradise by Jesus, the bridegroom and lover of our souls. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all our intentions, spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let's continue to pray for peace in the Holy Land and peace in Ukraine. We pray to the Lord. And God, our Father, we thank you that you can do more for us than we can ask for and imagine through your Son, Jesus, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Our hymn of preparation is number 387 in the music issue, The Summons, number 387.
Come and follow me if I but call your name. Will you go where you don't know and never be the same? Will you let my love be shown? Will you let my name be known? Will you let my life be grown in you and you in me? Will you leave yourself behind if I but call your name? Will you care for cruel and kind and never be the same? Will you raise across those stairs? Should your life attract or scare? Will you let me answer prayer in you? And you in me.
Will you bend the point and see if I have called your name? Will you set the prisoners free and never be to one?
Bring it over for me. Yeah.
And she may not be able to lift it. Yeah. Unseen, and to
yeah,
so,
so heavy, thank you. And then my challenge again.
Turn and follow you and never.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. By the mystery, it's water and wine. Come to share in the divinity of Christ. Who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Oh, holy, oh, holy, oh, holy, earth and God. Heaven and earth are full, of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning are ceaselessly at work, so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray, upon your people's offerings, and pour out on them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Indeed, though we once were lost and could not approach you, you loved us with the greatest love. For your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross. But before his arms were outstretched between heaven and earth in the everlasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. As he ate with them, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine and, once more giving you thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we
eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead, and looking forward to his blessed coming, we offer you, who are faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim who reconciles to you the human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, on those you unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as they partake of this one bread and one chalice, they may be gathered into one body in Christ who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart, together with Francis our Pope and Timothy our Bishop. Help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom. Until the hour we stand before you, saints among saints in the halls of heaven, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed apostles and all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we humbly commend to your mercy. Then freed at last from the wound of corruption and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ who lives for all eternity. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. 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 At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. But I'm not worthy to enter my roof, but only you say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 389 in the music issue, Here I Am, Lord, number 389.
those who are participating by YouTube, we'll do our act of spiritual communion written by St. Alphonsus Liguori. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come lay spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already here, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. For those of us who just received Holy Communion, we can say to Jesus, I embrace you because you're already here in my heart and in my soul. We'll take a few minutes of silence, then I'll say the closing communion prayer, and then we'll have Briella speak. Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those who have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart through Christ our Lord. Please be seated. You go back in. She's going back to the sacristy to get her notes. It's amazing how well these children read nowadays in good education, like Lourdes. When I was in her grade, I was struggling with C-spot run.
Hello, I am Brielle Hsu, a student at Our Lady of Lourdes Regional Catholic School. I feel blessed to have been a student at Lourdes since pre-kindergarten. At Lourdes, we receive a firm faith foundation, certainly a need in today's world. This parish takes seriously Pope Francis' plea that we transmit the faith of our families. Your presence at Mass each week, enrolling your child at Lourdes School, an evidence that you recognize the fact that grounding your children in faith is essential to living a virtual-based life, now and in the future. At the end of January, United States Catholic Schools will be celebrated Catholic Schools Week. The theme is Catholic Schools United in Faith and Community. At Lourdes Regional, we are a school where faith is a part of everything that we do, how we learn, how we play, and how we treat one another. Why choose Lourdes Regional? Because strong character is built in safe classrooms, led by dedicated and caring teachers who create surroundings to ensure the greatest potential for each student. We concentrate on academics, which in Catholic schools are held to the highest standard in mathematics, language arts, and the sciences. Service puts our faith in learning into action by giving loving service to our neighbor. We practice service, giving time, talent, and effort to help others as an expression of both faith and citizenship. This combined is a focus on faith and knowledge and service. In addition to extracurricular activities, enable our students to develop their talents fully. We invite you to come see what OLOL is the best at our upcoming open house on Sunday, January 28th, beginning at 2 p.m. Annual lecture, followed by tours, open house, registration, and make your own Sundays until 4 p.m. May God bless you and your families in a special way. Thank you, and have a wonderful rest of your day.
Thank you, Brielle. That was beautiful. It won't be long before she'll be one of our lectors. Please stand. The Lord be with you. Amen. Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Our recessional hymn is number 200 in the music issue, Blessed by Your Sacrifice, number 200.
Feel free to take a poinsettia up there by the American flag side altar. You can take them home, one or two or a couple. Yeah, feel free to take a poinsettia.